On any trekker's itinerary, Nepal is generally at the top of the list. For decades, its summits have been attracting scores of climbers, from those wishing to conquer Everest to others simply wanting a short walk through the still impressive lowlands. But trekking here is no longer just the domain of the backpacker. For many tourists, it's an opportunity to explore mountain village life in one of the world's most picturesque regions, without getting too many blisters.
For me, the mountains are everything they're made out of. The Himalayas don't disappoint. What you sort of build up in your mind right back home is what you get when you get here, actually.
Yeah, we're not disappointed at all.
It's like, so you're very satisfied.
Oh, yeah.
Walking throughout this country is a learning experience, particularly if you chance upon a hilltop school. Luxury hotels have now commenced helicopter jaunts and mid-range treks for travellers who like to ascend in style. You can travel to a mountain monastery for a champagne breakfast and be back at your resort in time for dinner.
The travellers are getting a bit more demanding as far as what they need and what they want. Even if they spend about a couple of nights out in the mountains, they still want to come back to a warm, hot shower, a good bed, and some comfort.
The tough decision is often where to begin. Why not travel in the footsteps of royalty? Britain's Prince Charles took the three-day Annapurna skyline trek. Not too strenuous, but the views are still stunning. Former Gurkha soldier Robin Marston was one of the prince's personal guides on a trek that included 13 guests, 32 Sherpas, 130 porters and two regiments of Nepalese soldiers. But the prince wasn't carried in a chair.
Oh, no. No, he was at that time very fit, actually. But he didn't need anybody to hold his hand. He was very fit. The one topic we weren't allowed to talk about was women. But allegedly it was about that time when he made the decision to marry Princess Di when he was up in the hills of Nepal.
Of course, the fit and fanatical will always head here to challenge the Himalayas. But a trekking holiday can also be a comfortable and rewarding experience for all ages and all levels of stamina. And if walking up a steep gradient still doesn't appeal, then you can always scale the heavens with fixed wings or rotors and take a bird's eye look at one of the most spectacular sights on Earth. Nepal is one of the most water-rich nations on Earth, with dramatic mountain rivers that wind their way through the country's mighty snow-capped peaks and into the lush green valleys below. Not surprisingly, with all these waterways to explore, the country has become one of the world's top destinations for whitewater rafting. But before you get to this stage, novices need a few pointers about rafting safety. Putting the life jacket and helmet on are the easy parts. Learning how to row out of a tough spot requires a little instruction.
So we might cut back. Otherwise,
your guides often can't resist a story or two about rescuing a man overboard or the last raft that happened to overturn.
I rescued the one person the next side, then after I pick up her. Then
I feel much better now. Thank you.
You're welcome.
But the rivers here can be both wild and mild, depending on your skill or preference. This rafting trip turned into a leisurely cruise on the Trisuli River through some spectacular scenery with a few little rapids to spice up the adventure. You can go rough riding on a week-long expedition or upmarket on a leisurely day trip, complete with a gourmet lunch on a sandy riverbank. There are numerous companies offering such trips with large, comfortable rafts but keep the ride relatively smooth.
The river rafting is the very most exciting sport also, and rafting also. And a lot of the clients, they are going for river rafting for the adventure and like fun also.
A trip like this can cost about $30 US for the day, including lunch. An 8-day trek will cost about $300 per person. For five-star junkies, it's an exciting but none too strenuous day out. Of course, there are much more exhilarating rapids for the experts. The best times for rafting in Nepal are late September to early December, and March to May.